Okay, I thought this would be a good time to talk a little bit about workflow. This actually doesn't introduce any new concepts of Git. It's just kind of talking about a workflow that I've adopted, and I think that a lot of people kind of have adopted that kind of works well for me and has worked well for others. But when it comes to Git, it's really about designing your own workflow. But this may be a good starting point for those who are kind of just getting into Git. So now that you guys all understand branching, Git push, Git fetch, Git pull requests, all this kind of stuff like that, you can kind of really put this all together in a workflow, right? So how would you go about working on this stuff, right? So really, it all starts with you're setting up your own project, right? So kind of one of the first things you want to do really is just, create your folder and create your repository on your local box, right? So you would create your, your project folder and you would add files, right? You would add files there and you'd do whatever you want with that, right? If you're doing like these projects like Rails, Ruby on Rails projects, this all these folders are created for you, right? And the very first thing you want to do, obviously, that we talked about is git init. Okay, so this is really about kind of like starting off. This is really about kicking off a project. You want to do a git init. And then what you want to also do is you want to create a GitHub repository. I should mention there are other alternatives to GitHub. One is called Bitbucket. It's pretty similar to GitHub. Not as popular, not as full featured, but the important thing is it is free in terms of private repositories, which is really nice. And then what you want to do at that point is you want to do a git push origin master. Okay, and that's really how you want to set up your project. You're good to go there, right? Okay, now let's say you want to start collaborating with people. What you want to do there is you want to go onto GitHub and basically just add users, add collaborators. So I'll show you this. If you go onto GitHub on your project, and let's say you've managed this project, all you really want to do is go to the admin section of your project and go to collaborators. And here you can just start adding people, right? So you can add anybody that has a GitHub account. You can just ask for their username and that'll be good to go. Okay? And you just add them. Now, what adding them does is that gives them the ability to push, pull, see all the GitHub information. So that's really nice for collaborating. Okay, so now let's get into the meat of things. What happens when you're actually doing your work? Okay, so we know all this getting started collaborating. What happens when you actually want to start doing your work? Okay, so if you were the person who created the project, no biggie, you've already had the project on your machine. If you're not, if you're a collaborator, you can just do a git clone, right? And you can grab the URL from GitHub itself, right? If you go to your GitHub repository, these are the URLs here. I tend to use SSH, but you can use the other ones as well. Okay, so what happens when you work? Okay, before I do any work at all, okay, I always want to make sure what I'm working with is up to date with GitHub. That's how I generally work, right? When I sit down to do some work and other people are collaborating, what I want to always do is I always do a git fetch. Okay, and then any branches that I'm working on, I always update those branches. Okay, so if it's master, I check out the master and I merge the master, and any other branches that I happen to be working with, right? I'll do that. Okay, so now my repository is looking nice and fresh and it's up to date with GitHub. That's the first thing I do. Then after that point, there's two paths I could go, right? I could actually go with kind of private branches. So what I mean by private, it's not a Git concept, it's just internally what you think about it. What I consider a private branch is a branch that I'm going to be developing and I'm going to be merging myself and no one else needs to know about this, okay? So my flow there is typically you do a git checkout. My branch, okay? So this dash B basically creates the branch and checks out to that branch all in one step. Then I do work. Okay, let me make this font a bit smaller so it can kind of fit. Then I do some work, I add the files, I commit the files. Okay, and I continue to do this until I'm ready to merge back into master. And when I'm in master, then all I have to do is this. Whoops. My branch. Okay. So that's for private branches. Again, branches that I don't need anybody else to know, right? And I can, and this doesn't always have to be off master, right? Maybe there's a my branch, I want to branch off that and then merge back into that branch. You can do whatever you want with that, right? So that's private branches. For non-private branches, so branches that I want other people to know about and I want other people to merge, I want to send pull requests and stuff like that. It's a very similar process, except what happens is I check out and create a branch. I do work. Okay, let's put this on one page so you can actually see it. So for non-private branches, I check out my branch, I do work, I add the files, I commit them. Then, instead of doing the merge, as I would here, I push it up to GitHub. And then I create a pull request and let someone else merge it. Once that someone else is merged, then I do another fetch and a merge of my master or whatever branch I happen to be checking out to. Okay. So that's my general workflow. Now this is usually for any project that I'm just working basically by myself. Sometimes I do pull requests just to kind of get in the habit of it. And this is for projects that I'm working with other people. This is kind of the workflow that I generally do, okay? And I kind of want to diagram this workflow out for you guys, the non-private branches. Basically what's happening, the workflow you kind of want to picture in your mind, okay? Local box. GitHub, what you have in your local box is a master branch and a my branch. And on GitHub, you have the same thing. What you want to picture the workflow in terms of this is you always want to picture this workflow. You're making changes to my branch too. Send it up to GitHub. Send it up to GitHub. Create a pull request. Somebody merges it actually into master. And then you do a fetch and a merge back down, okay? This is the workflow when you're collaborating with people. From your local box, up to GitHub, pull request, down back to your box is the kind of workflow you want to picture when it comes to working with other people. Okay? So that's a quick thing on workflow. That's how I work these days on all my GitHub projects, okay? And again, this also works with Bitbucket or any other Git repositories. If you're running a Git server on your own, in your own company, this is what you can do. Okay? So you create the project, push it up to GitHub, add users and collaborate them. Always bring your local stuff up to date first, and then you can start doing your work. And if you're doing work that involves other people, you can push it up to GitHub, create a pull request, and then merge it back down. That's it for workflow.